We are coming to you live tonight for a little intro commercial to see what we're up to. As a mom, but also as a pediatric therapist, we often hear of parents being told, well, you just have to wait and see, or my child did that and they were just fine. And we have the opinion opposite, that a parent should not wait and see. So earlier today, I was actually just talking to one of my girlfriends, and she had mentioned how her pediatrician had told her daughter, who's 9 months old, who she has a little bit of a concern about her having tongue thrust that's still going on. And her pediatrician told her, well, we should wait until 18 months. And again, as a therapist, we're truly thinking that you should really start intervention early and get a therapist perspective. I'm going to hand it over to Heidi.
Hi, I'm Heidi Miller. I'm in New Jersey, and I am a pediatric speech language pathologist and feeding specialist. And I often get that question, when should we intervene? Should I wait? My kid's not talking, but he's two, he's a boy. My doctor says it's okay. Or my child only eats a couple of foods. Maybe he's just picky. For something like the tongue thrust, usually you would talk to an oral facial myologist or somebody that knows something like that. So there are so many questions out there, and we are here to answer those kinds of questions. A lot of times with the babies, you see, I'll have a baby that will come in that I see, and they could have a little bit of like a flat head or a torticollis. And they think, okay, maybe it'll go away on its own. And that's when you would have to consult somebody like a pediatric physical therapist like Stacy, so she can share her knowledge on that. I'm passing it on to her.
Hi, I'm Stacy Menz from Starfish Therapies in the San Francisco Bay Area of California. And so that is great. So one of the ones that we hear a lot is, well, there's a lot that we hear a lot, but one of the ones with, I'm a mom also, and it comes up a lot with walking. My child's not walking yet, or is your child walking yet? And there is a range. So we're very well aware of that range. But what I like to ask is, what is your child doing? Because if your child's 12 months and they're still struggling to sit, no, we're not going to wait till the 15-month mark to intervene. I always believe, like, if your gut is making you ask the question, it's better to go get a professional opinion or have a therapist assess. So that way, either you'll get a couple tips and you will be good to go, or you will, you know that everything is fine, or you'll get the help that your little one needs so that they're not getting further behind. And I am going to pass it off to Kim, who is an occupational therapist.
Hi guys, I'm Kimberly Bradley, pediatric occupational therapist at Kim for Kids in New Orleans, Louisiana. Can reiterate everything that these wonderful women professionals are saying about early intervention. But after practicing 20 years, it's don't wait and see. As a parent, you have a right to go get an evaluation with a physical therapist, speech therapist, or an occupational therapist, and just to look at those developmental milestones and to get an opinion from a professional that specifically works with kids in those areas. So I'm ready to help y'all, and when you shouldn't wait and see, and that you can do something about it. I'm going to toss it over to Amy to wrap it up.
Hi, everyone. I'm Amy Whedon. I'm a pediatric occupational therapist at KidShine LLC, and we're on the North Shore of Massachusetts, just north of Boston. And one of the things that we hear a lot as OTs is, oh, my child is super active, especially with boys. My son is super active. And, the pediatrician says, they're just going to grow out of it, or he's just being a boy. But when is that something that they're going to grow out of, or something that is interfering with their ability to participate in their daily occupations, making it harder for them to focus in school, making it harder for them at home to be able to participate in dressing routines or meals, or be safe in the grocery store? So we hear that all the time, and we're here to help as pediatric OTs. And I am so excited about this panel that we're going to have. All five of us are here to answer any questions that you have. If you have questions that you'd like to throw in the chat right now that you'd like us to address, you can feel free to go ahead and do that, but definitely stay tuned on Monday, May 3rd. It's at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and help me out with the Central Time and the West Coast Time.
On Monday, May 3rd again.
Yeah, so 7:30 Central Time, 6:30
California
time, and 5:30 Pacific time. So yes, so 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific, and figure out the other ones in between. And we're super excited. Send us questions via our Facebook, via our Instagram, and we will be ready to answer them. Thanks, everybody.
Bye.
See you soon.